Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the master of mayhem, Craig Charles.
Already, the name Extreme is striking fear into the heart of every robot, because this is where only the best fight, but nearly all are sadly destroyed. But do we really care? It's about action, destruction. It's about fear and courage. But tonight is also about flippers. Flippin' heck, it's our flipper frenzy.
That's right, Craig, it's our main event of the night. A fabulous, frenetic flipper frenzy. Thermidor 2, Bigger Brother, Chaos 2, Wheelie Big Cheese, all together. The challenge belt tonight has the holder Tornado against Wild Thing. If Tornado wins, they keep the belt. The Tag Team Terror second semi-final has Diotor and Megamorg against Come and Getrix and Spawn Again. Then we have the Wildcard Warriors newcomers, the Executioner against the Experienced Dominator 2. The Mayhem, Napalm, Gemini and the Spider, only one survives to go through to our Annihilator later in the series. And there's that main event once again. It's our Flipper Frenzy!
The Battle of the Flippers. Am I looking forward to that or what? But hey, on Extreme, it's action all the way. Because, Julia, I hear there's some other red-hot news in the pits.
Your take is white-hot. Because, as you'll remember, a couple of shows ago, Tornado successfully defended their challenge belt for the second time running. But now, a new challenger has come forward, and it's Wild Thing. Why are you going to fight them for this belt?
Yeah, well, they've had two fights so far, and they look pretty easy for Tornado. Now they're just laid back, just waiting to take that belt home. But we're going to get in there and show them it's not easy at all. And we're really going to take it off of them.
OK, any last thoughts on that?
Tornado are going to be a breeze.
OK, they've thrown down the gauntlet. Are Tornado up to it? Tornado, do you agree to accept the challenge of Wild Thing?
Wild Thing, what do we think, guys?
Got to be done.
Okay.
Have you fought them before?
We've never fought them before, but we know they are a good robot.
And if you win this, you get to keep the challenge belt, so it's important. Agreed?
Oh, yes.
Well, they accept the challenge. The audience is waiting for them. Wild Thing is waiting for them. Let's see some action.
So, who'll be wearing that challenge belt after this? Hey, let the wars begin!
From Ash in Hampshire, Wild Thing.
Twice a semi-finalist in Robot Wars now, going extreme with a new giant cutting disc spinning at 6,000 RPM, also has a 3-mech and is the heavier of the two at 100 kilos.
Hi, we're the Wild Thing team, and I'm Isabel, this is...
Jake.
And...
Nick.
We've been here before, and we've upgraded the robot so that we now have a spinner disc, and we aim to win.
From Huntingdon, Tornado.
A semi-finalist in Robot Wars 4, it's a nippy welded steel box on wheels with a vertically mounted spinning disc and the ability to run both ways up. Yes, Tornado can put the wind up anyone.
Hi, my name's Andrew Marchant. This is Brian Moss. This is David Gamble. We are Team Tornado. Remember how we pushed all the other robots around last year? Well, we're going to do the same this year, and this year we have this. Everybody, beware.
So, beware those venomous, cutting, spinning discs, our two house robots. Matilda first up with the flywheel herself, 27 kilos, heavy, powerful. And alongside her, the trusty Knight of the Realm, Sir Killalot.
Roboteers, stand by. 3, 2, 1.
Don't forget, Tornado has 2 challenge belt victories. Another one here against Wild Thing, and they would keep the belt outright. Battle here between 2 spinning discs. That on top of Wild Thing is the fastest we've seen. Uses 6,000 revs per minute, but the more distractive early on is Tornado's at the front there, and certainly with the thrust again, Tornado. Up to 10 miles an hour, top speeds, using 97 kilos of slam. Against the arena sidewall and the angle grind there, you can still see the spinning disc on top of Wild Thing rotating. It's got the lifting arm as well. And Tornado's a little nagger. It nags and worries opposition. We've seen it so far in Extreme. Very impressive, the Tornado boys. Andrew Marchant, Just caught a glimpse there of Brian Moss from behind with the long hair. Now, can you see that front spinning disc, the cutting disc on Tornado, trying to gnaw away at Wild Thing? And look at the damage on the side of Wild Thing there. There's a hole also at the back just above the wheel. And certainly Nick Adams at the control of Wild Thing looked concerned, didn't he? Brave to challenge here. The impressive Tornado into the CPZ they go. Wild Thing out and about once again. They too can muster top speeds of 10 miles an hour. On the side there of that spinning disc, two cutting blades to wreak destruction, Wild Thing. But in comes Killalot. Steam is vented on the arena floor. You can also see the rear spike there at the back of the arm, Wild Thing. So plenty of weaponry, but at the moment not causing too much disruption. They simply can't get a Tornado, and something's come off the side there of Wild Thing. Some of the armor plating has flown off for Wild Thing. That leaves the wheel vulnerable as well. Look at that, you can see it simply cut away. That again is that Tornado disc at the front, and Killalot also has Wild Thing pinned in now. Well, the eyes at the moment staring, but staring defeat in the face, Wild Thing. Tornado gets in underneath, and I don't know whether Wild Thing can right themselves. They can, using the arm well. It doubles as a streamer as well, as a lifting weapon. The pit descends. Tornado getting away from Wild Thing, sensing perhaps one or two more frontal assaults on the Adams family will leave Wild Thing down in a pit. Killalot's claw trying to gain purchase on, I think, that cutting disc. In on the side, can't tear, can grip but not crumple. Killalot is vast, massive, heavy, foreboding, ominous. Look at the horrible, evil twinkle in the eyes. Refbot comes in with just a little bit of a look. Tornado's done all the work here, and he's heading, I think, to take that belt back into the trophy cabinet, unless Nick Adams can do something very, very quick. They certainly are coming back here, Wild Thing, and the judges will be impressed with the tenacity of the thing if it goes to a decision. Killalot, a little nip, a little bend and a buckle. Still Wild Thing on the attack again. Tornado, therefore, pushed back towards Killalot. That is dangerous. And Tornado and Andrew Marchant has left Tornado vulnerable there to Killalot. They just got away. They were fortunate. That wasn't great driving skill there by Andrew on the left-hand side. Look at the concentration. Nick Adams, bead of perspiration on the brow. And it's been a dogged battle. One of the wheels looks very, very buckled. It will go to the judges. That was a splendid contest of durability, I felt. Well done, the Tornado boys and Nick and his team.
Well, Wild Thing worthy challengers, but we're going to have to go to the judges. Have they done enough to wrestle the belt from Tornado's grasp? It's up to them. The judges have made their decision. You know the criteria: style, control, damage, and aggression. Now, they said it was very, very close, but they've gone winners on aggression are Tornado! I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry. Hey, hey, hey. What's all this here?
I had my own challenge belt, my sister.
Your sister did that?
Yeah.
Why did you do that to him?
He bit me.
He bit you? Why did you bite her?
I only bit her because you're trying to take the weapons control off me.
Wasn't he doing a good enough job or something?
No.
Never mind, guys. They gave it to the judges on aggression.
The judges again. I hate those judges.
I know, but you always seem to lose on judge decisions, don't you?
Yeah, I think they fall asleep halfway through, and then when we're doing well at the end, they're not watching or talking or gone off.
They're probably turned over and watching the cricket or something. Yeah.
Well, no, it was a good fight, really good fight, and I hope the audience liked it.
Well, we'll ask them, did you like that fight? I think they did. Let's hear it. Good challenges. Wild Thing!
It was a very difficult fight.
You want
they
an aggression.
Did
you're wrong.
Not stop.
They never stop, though. They always keep going on and on and on. And he was right, though. They get stronger towards the end of the battle. Mm. And maybe sometimes that's not taken into consideration. They've lost a few times when I've thought, well, they're really quite strong towards the end of a battle.
Whereas
you know?
We were getting a bit weaker towards the end. Our batteries were just starting to go. So yeah, they did very, very well. but you've done the hat trick, which means you get to keep this belt, but like, don't go very far with it. Because you know, there's loads of robots out there, some big, some bad, and some angry, and they're all gonna wanna challenge you for the Extreme yeah. Challenge belt. Now, are you prepared? Are you prepared to take up those challenges?
Of course.
Alrighty, well, we'll see more Extreme Challenges in the future, but for now, three times winners, you get to keep the belt. Let's hear it for Tornado! Now, think of the most awesome flippers in the wars. Wheelie Big Cheese, Thermidor, Bigger Brother, and Chaos 2. Then, imagine them in the war zone together. Well, tonight, we're gonna make it happen.
Well, Craig, our main event tonight is a fantastic flipper frenzy. We have four of the most ferocious flippers lined up to take part. They're all gonna flip, some of them are gonna flop, and one of them might even fly. But it wouldn't be a flipper competition without Chaos 2, now would it?
No, it wouldn't, no.
What is your main claim to flipper fame?
We were the first to get somebody over the fence.
And how many times have you done that now?
Sorry, lost count.
Bigger Brother, what's special about your flipper, Ellie? You going to tell us?
There's a backward flip under it.
Thermidor.
Hello.
Have you had much success with your flipper in the past?
We certainly have.
You're confident?
Very confident.
Because I think of you as more of a pincer than a flipper.
Oh no, the pincers are just there for show. Be very wary of the flipper.
Good luck, team. Wheelie Big Cheese, who's going to win then?
They are.
Flipping mental.
Amongst all these bloody and brutal battles, there's something else at stake too. Because for one tag team, winning this next fight will mean a place in the tag team finals. So, are we up for a tag team terror? Yeah! Then let's go ahead. I'll make your day.
Some pedigree here. Diator and Megamorg beat King B3 and 101, the reigning champions, last time out. They're against Come and Getrix and Spawn again this time around.
We're preparing for the tag team semi-finals. Diator and Megamorg looking quite confident. Now you're up against Spawn again and Come and Getrix. Chances?
Not a bother. You know what I mean? The last was the world championship.
Exactly. You've already taken out the favourites, haven't
you? We are the
world
champions.
Yeah. He's confident. Technically all okay? You're bonding as a team?
Technically, we've got bits of them in ours and they've got bits of us in them.
I don't think I want to hear about that. Good luck, team. We're Spawn again and Come and Getrix. I've just met your opponents and they do seem very confident indeed having taken out the last winners.
They might be small, furry and cute, but with their style and their good looks, we can't lose.
Nah. You do seem to have better weapons than them for sure.
We've got better weapons than most people.
Confident in them?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah?
Lift them, smash them, cut them to bits.
Yes. And whoever wins this gets a place in the final.
So the scene is set. No, it isn't. I'm hearing that Megamorg have got problems. Jules, get in there and find out what's going on.
Megamorg, what's happening? We need you in the arena as soon as possible.
This is what's happening. Blown three controllers in three different battles. We're out of it.
Rest in pieces, Megamorg.
Yeah, but we're not going to bleed about it.
I better find them a replacement quick.
Who is that replacement for Megamorg? It's Pussycat and Diator now against Come and Getrix and Spawn again. And out they come, into the arena, Spawn again to the right. There's the dangerous Pussycat. David Gribble there on the left of the controls. Up with the Diator boys, out comes Come and Getrix. There's Diator once again. Back of their fur line team. We know Diator's problem, the fur brain machine catches fire, has a zero ground clearance, so difficult to flip, and a zero turning circle as well. Very manoeuvrable.
Hi, I'm Kieran Bourne. I'm the armor. This is Pete Redmond. He's the captain. And Joe Gavin, the electrician. This is the robot Diator 2. We're here to kick ass and chew bubblegum. And we're all out of gum.
And there they spawn again, boys. Let's have a look at their machine. Twice the series semi-finalists as a high-powered CO2 flipper at the front, a spike at the back. The 12-volt battery can generate an astonishing 25 miles an hour.
We're a spawn again team. As you can see, the Essex boys have got a new robot this year. With same power, but a big bad flipper this year. Anyone who wants to go up against us in the arena better be prepared to go into orbit.
Next up, let's have a look at Pussycat. Driven by David Gribble there on the left is Dan Allen, in the background Robert Bettington. A Robot Wars veteran, the rotary blade powered by a 24 brake horsepower motor can cause real problems. The chassis, aluminium and polycarbonate.
Hi, we're the Cold Fusion team. I'm Al Gribble. This is Dave, the driver, Robert, our weapons man, and this is our robot Pussycat. This is our new two-tooth blade, which will cut through just about anything.
And finally, come and get her, we've seen before in another guise. This is the remodeled Warvet Versing Getrix, which fought in previous series. It has an axe lifter flipper Sremec, which can hoist 200 kilos, but it's not very reliable.
Hi, we're Team Come and Getrix this year. We were Versing Getrix. This is Ian, team captain. I'm Alistair, and this is the sleeping partner, Tom. Amongst our weaponry, we have a lifter, sarcasm written on the front, and an axe. So that people will get the point.
Oh, we do, Alistair. So do the house robots, Matilda, with the tough exoskeleton. And alongside her in the arena, Shunt can push anything in Robot Wars.
Roboteers, stand by.
The ref bot checks the arena. We check the pods. Yep, we're ready to go, go, go. Green light for go. And the tag team Terror, semi-final. The second semi-final is off and underway. Pussycat out there with Spawn Again. Spawn Again across the flame pit. Watch for that Pussycat patented blade. Can tear and slice into anything. Spawn Again has the flipper. Spawn Again just moving rather sluggishly. Can actually get up to 25 miles an hour top speeds. But I think they're in trouble, Spawn Again. No, they're not. They come out of the arena sidewall. They looked a little bit sluggish and ponderous for me. But they've got Pussycat on the run here. Pussycat into the CPZ. Needs to get out because Matilda's in there with the tusks. Of course, Pussycat can run any which way up, really, on those four wheels. They're the Pussycat and Geotour team. Pussycat nudges the arena release button, which crumples and breaks. Come and Getrix has been tagged, is out there. Pussycat goes back into the TPZ. There's the tag to allow Geotour to come in. Geotour, great sports, good fun, always have been. But what was that? Spawn Again are out and in the arena, and that's not right. Pussycat have flown out of... Also, there, Kitty Lair to come back into the fight, even things up, but Spawn Again broke the rules. The rules! Are there any ref bot, really? Let's be honest, this is Tag Team Terror. We don't want rules. We want mechanical mayhem, maniacal mashing out there, and that's what we're getting now in this Tag Team Terror. Geotour gets the bucket scoop underneath. Come and Getrix. Come and help. Come and Getrix says to Spawn Again. He needs a little bit of assistance. Good push by Geotour. In comes Pussycat on the side of Come and Getrix, up and over the top. Spawn Again, have they been immobilized? They're moving, they are. But they have these periods of inactivity, Spawn Again, which are most frustrating. I think the Pussycat and Geotour team are on top at this moment in time. There again, Spawn Again stopped. Come and Getrix is being pushed around by Geotour. The Spawn Again boys, oops, I think one of them just said. I don't think they've had control of that all the way through. Not consistent control anyway. Spawn Again on the right there. They're being counted out by the ref bot. It was inevitable, so Spawn Again have gone. It means, of course, that Shunt can come out with the axe and finish Spawn Again onto the floor flipper. Come on, let's see the Spawn fly through the air. Great stuff. The crowd love that flipper. There you can see the CO2 bottle underneath. Fire extinguisher type weapon. And there you see Matilda with the coup de grace. Spawn Again in the pit. Well, that team on the left-hand side have gone. In the pit, ignominy. From the flipper through the air. The heights of success almost there, within touching distance. And then the pits of despair confirmed. Well done, Matilda. One down, one to go. Come and get her, it's there. And somehow Diator, somehow it always happens. Why am I baffled? He's on fire. Diator's always on fire. Fur brain flammable. Foolish design. No, we love the Diator boys. They've done tremendously well to get to this stage, I think. In the tag team terror. And come and get her, it would have been in the pit. Had not its fallen teammate helped them out. In the end, it matters not one jot. One out, both out, and it's Diator and Pussycat that'll go through. Come and get it and spawn again, the Fallen. They're disappointed, ending in defeat.
Come and get it and spawn again. They take a right beating through to the final. Diator and a transfer. Diator and Pussycat, come out, lads.
Guys, so, how do you feel about that?
Well, these things happen. Their little kill switch fell out, and that was it.
So it was you that... Did they let you down, then, did they? What happened there, then?
Well, our kill switch came out. I mean, that's it. It was dead.
Are you a bit annoyed, though, that Megamorgue wasn't with Diator there? Because Megamorgue is not as powerful a robot as Pussycat.
Well, no, it's not. It's not, no.
Yeah?
No, yeah. No, I'll see what you're getting at here. Yeah.
So you feel a little bit cheated, a bit let down?
Oh, I do, yeah. Extremely.
Okay.
Yeah. I think I might,
lodge a complaint?
Exactly.
Have an appeal?
I will.
Yes. Go down, hassle him in the pits, all right?
I will. Derek loves that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Talk to me about this transfer, then.
Pussycat was happy to step in, because... we couldn't have asked for a better enemy, you know what I mean?
I tell you what, though. I mean, you know, you've got a great robot... You got a great robot there, but then the saw didn't seem to be working out well.
We had a bit of problem with the saw, but I don't know what his interference or what it was. They were very, very, very lucky. And as for appealing, they don't appeal to us at all.
Okay, let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen, for Diator and Pussycat!
Craig, let's just confirm the lineup for the Tag Team Terror Final. Diator and Pussycat will meet the Steel Avenger and Suicidal Tendencies.
Now, as you know, newcomers to the wars have to earn the right to fight. And on Extreme, that means taking on some of the veterans. Now, we'll be meeting the Robo Rookies in a minute, but the team that are going to take them on is Dominator 2, the veterans. Now, team, what do you think the secret of your success has been so far? Why are you such a nails robot?
Well, it's a good design, it's reliable, fast, and it's got the axe of doom.
Ooh, confident?
We are.
Well, I've been having a little snoop around the pits, and I have met your opposition. And they say that you keep banging on about your plasma nitride-coated titanium protection, which apparently is nothing more than paint.
Well, if that's what they think, let's get him out of arena now.
And the Executioner team, welcome to the wars, but that is where the niceties stop, because you're drawn up against Dominator 2, and it's not going to be pretty. What do you reckon? What have you got to throw back at them?
It's going to be a doddle. Who are Dominator 2? Let's face it, it's a triangular-shaped box. Plasma nitride coated. What is that? It's paint. It's paint! Plasma nitride.
So you're confident?
It's going to do the business.
Have you got
a message
for them?
Go straight through them. Go home, guys. You're going to get trashed.
From Huntingdon, Dominator 2.
A Series 4 semi-finalist, now improved with a unique bi-wedge shape and 12 kilos of slam from the pneumatic axe. It has a plasma nitride-coated titanium shell.
From Stanbrand, the Executioner.
The 22-ton front-mounted hydraulic cutting blade is designed to split and crush. It's powered by American motors. It can run upside down. It doesn't need a Sremec. And once again, we've thrown in two house robots, Matilda with the tusks, and watch for that flywheel. It's devastating at the rear. Fighting with Matilda for us, Shunt with the diamond-edge axe, the scoop, and the electric motor.
Roboteers, stand by. 3, 2, 1, 2, 8.
So we have green light for go from the ref bot and immediately Dominator 2 after the executioner tries to press that pit release button once and twice and misses. Not great control then, and 3 times I think they've done it just about at the end. Press the pit release button. Yes, there it goes. So what's the executioner going to do with it? Oh my goodness me! They threw themselves straight into the pit! Well, it took them long enough to activate the pit release, and as soon as they did it, they went straight down. Mark Nenadic, Ian Sanford, and young David. Well, they were big with the bravado, but out there, little control.
The executioner executed itself. Dominator is the winner! How long did it take to build a robot?
18 months.
And 18 seconds, and you're in the pit.
Yeah, we're doing really well.
We're
on a roll.
You're a wild card entry. You're fighting for the right to come and join the Robot Wars family. I'm going to ask the audience, do you think we should allow this robot into the Robot Wars family?
Yes!
Not sure. They're not sure.
I wouldn't be.
And neither am I. I must be honest. I think we'll give you a chance one more time to prove yourselves another time. Because that was just pure accident, wasn't it?
It was a bit unfortunate, yeah.
Never mind.
I'm never going to live it down, am I? Let's face it. It's going to haunt me for the rest of my life, this moment.
Retribution enough,
you know,
actually.
My 5 minutes of fame. What's happened?
Turned to 18 seconds, didn't it? Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for the executioner! I'm talking to you, isn't it?
No.
You didn't do anything. So bye-bye then. Ladies and gentlemen, Dominator 2!
The war zone is no place for a robot tonight, I can tell you, chaps. And you know what? That's got me fired up for a mayhem! Are you with me? Are you with me? Then let's go mental!
Our mayhem pits Napalm and Gemini and the Spider together. One robot will survive and make it through to the Annihilator later in the series.
Mayhem time, and we've got 3 brave, possibly slightly foolish robots waiting in the pits. The first team is Spider. Hello again.
Hello.
Now, we remember you from a couple of shows ago, because you were a wild card, weren't you? You hadn't fought before with this robot, and you went up against Behemoth. And tell us what happened.
Well, it was a bit short. We just sort of went into the middle of the arena, and we ended up flipped out.
They flipped you right out of the arena.
Yeah.
And did you do anything to them at all?
Not a lot.
No. Okay. So, are you confident about this fight then? 2 robots
Absolutely,
to face.
Yeah. Why not? I mean, we're as good as anybody.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you have a strategy for this?
Probably get flipped a lot by Gemini and try and go for Napalm, because I think Napalm's a bit weaker than us. I hope.
Napalm, you are veterans of the wars.
Ancient veterans, yes.
And Spider have just called you weak.
Upstarts. Upstarts. Have you seen their fight? Call it a fight? Ha! They were in there, 4 seconds flat, and boom, out of the arena.
So we're not scared of them then, obviously.
Scared of spiders, arachnophobia, no chance.
All right, Napalm.
Thank you.
Best of luck to you. Gemini. Napalm or Spider? Who are you going to go for first?
Whichever one gets there first.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hopefully, yeah. Napalm. We've been been waiting for a fight with Napalm for a couple of years now.
So. Any particular reason?
Well, just to get rid of it once and for all, really.
From New Ash Green, Longfield in Kent, Napalm.
A large titanium-hulled wedge with vicious snarling fangs, they say, at the back, steel spikes attached to a rotary arm. To me, it looks like a garden pitchfork, to be honest.
bold in Flintshire, the Spider.
The weaponry here is a set of rotating spikes. It can work upside down. It has a metal frame, but there's no armour. It's weak and vulnerable.
From St Leonard's-on-Sea, East Sussex, Gemini.
The inspired engineering of Gemini, a cluster bot. It can split in two. Both machines have high-powered flippers, but it is difficult to control. The house robots in the arena. Matilda once again. Watch for the tusks at the front. Watch for the rear end. And Shunt, who will be closely watching Matilda's rear end, I can tell you.
Roboteers, stand by.
This for a place in our Annihilator later in the series. The Gemini clusterbot immediately splits and comes in on the attack. Both sides of the Spider. Kind of weave a web out there. Gemini tries to flick using those lifting weapons, the high-powered flipper. There's Napalm just staying out a little bit of trouble on the right-hand side, backing away. One of those Gemini cluster bots is up on its end. It'll need to come down. Don't forget, if one part of Gemini is immobilized, the robot is out. Both still happily running. What on earth is the Spider doing there? The web's going to catch fire. The Spider's going to catch fire. Oh, no. Come into my parlor, said the Spider to the fly. And that is what we have said to our Spider. An incy wincy Spidey. You're up the robot war spout. You've had it. That leaves Gemini and also Napalm. And Napalm's on its side. Spider is a smoking and counted out by the ref bot. They've gone. They've had a disastrous time in Robot Wars Extreme, haven't they? John and Carol Udall and young Robert, the 12-year-old. So Gemini, wobble, wibble, wobble, wibble, wobble. Is it going to be Napalm with victory on a plate? Because Gemini have been counted out by the ref bot. Well, somehow Napalm has contrived an unbelievable victory without hardly doing anything. How on earth did that happen? Gemini once again flattering to deceive, and the Spider was awful. All that work and creativity, look at the design and the ingenuity behind Gemini and the cluster bot. Onto the floor flipper goes the Spider. Ever seen a spider fly? You're about to. Watch this. Nice little bit of positioning by the Shunt. And the Spider flies. All that work. Carol's an art teacher. She would have designed that Spider logo, I'm sure. Look at that. Through the air. Burnt to a crisp early on. All control gone. Looks dangerous. Wasn't. And Gemini's so disappointing. The pit descends. And Napalm with a little glance. There, of course, is Shunt on the Spider. Well, Gemini's finally come to life again. That's far too late. Counted out by the ref bot. Look, I've had enough, says Shunt. You can all go down there. Skull and crossbones and just about everything. What a heap. What a mess. And Napalm are through. They ended up in the pit, look. But it doesn't matter. Gemini went with them and Gemini were immobilised a long, long time ago. Well done, Napalm.
Unbelievably, Napalm are the winner. Gemini and Spider both immobilised. Napalm go through to the Annihilator!
Through to the Annihilator, but if you think about it, aren't you just going to be cannon fodder in that?
I've got no objection to that at all. We're used to it.
Are you surprised that you won?
Very surprised. I mean, we're actually sitting down there ready to win. It just didn't work at all. So we had to unplug a few plugs. We plugged them back in all sorts of ways. So therefore, we didn't know which control activated which servo, which activated which thing. So basically, it was all over the place.
Nothing like being prepared, eh? Okay, you're through anyway.
We are indeed.
Robot Wars Extreme.
Yep.
There was nothing extreme about that, apart from the damage.
Apart from the damage, yes. Damage.
That's how it gets more extreme later in the Annihilator. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Napalm! Okay, folks, settle down. Settle down. Settle down. This is it. And I think you know what's coming. Stand well away from the war zone, everybody. Because at last, right here, right now, for you lucky people, it's all flipper frenzy! So, time to find out if robots can fly. And while they let it flip, you let it rip for Chaos 2! Wheelie Big Cheese! Thermidor! And Bigger Brother!
Beaten in the semi-finals of the fourth wars on a judge's decision. I love that massive titanium throw. It can toss 800 kilos, powered by two golf cart motors. I wonder if it'll be hard cheddar for the opponents.
Hello, I'm Roger. This is Murray. This is John. We're the Wheelie Big Cheese team from Somerset. This is our robot, all built out of titanium. Toughest robot on the block. Here to smash everything else to bits.
The lobster with the claws and that very strong pneumatic CO2 flipper, 15 miles an hour top speed, 95 kilos in weight. Only Pussycat could stop this in the fourth series of the wars.
We're Team Lobster. My name's Dave. This is Ian. This is our robot Thermidor 2. We're angry. We're ready for a fight. Keep out of our way.
This CO2-powered gas ram spiked flipper comes from an industrial digger. Zero ground clearance, 96 kilos, 12 miles an hour top speeds.
My name is Ellie, and this is my brother, Joe, and over here is my daddy, Ian, and this is our secret weapon, a flipper, and this robot is called Bigger Brother.
Chaos 2 has never been beaten. It's the reigning British champion. The CO2 flipper is one of the most powerful ever seen. It's thrown more robots out of the arena than any other machine in history. Think you can be successful? Don't forget, there's many a flip, twixt cup and lip, and we have house robots in there, like the heavyweight Matilda with the tusks and the flywheel. And alongside Matilda and fighting for us, Sergeant Bash. Watch for its flamethrower. But what a battle of the flippers we have ahead here.
Roboteers, stand by. 3, 2, 1, do it.
So, who has the bigger flipper? Chaos 2, top of the picture. Thermidor goes in for, well, a tentative look, nothing more. Out comes Bash! Thermidor gets the first flip in on Bash, who retreats away to fight another day, and he's toppled. Look at this, Thermidor straight in. Up goes the flipper, Bash flies. Chaos 2 wanted some of the action, and Bigger Brother 2 for that matter. And there goes Bash, toppled by Bigger Brother. Already we can see the power of these pneumatic flippers. This is Wheelie Big Cheese, under pressure from Matilda, and takes a bit of a bash. Wheelie Big Cheese, got those little spikes on the wheels, that's the end of Bash. Wheelie Big Cheese now, under pressure from Matilda there on the arena sidewall. And Chaos 2 slamming into the pit release button. You can hear the siren activated. There's something strange going on, you know, out there. All the robots are attacking the house robots. No one's having a go at each other. Is this some sort of conspiracy against our machines? You dastardly competitors, you. This is not in the rules of house roboteering. I'm sure our poor robot, Bash, look, they're ganging up on him. Killalot, remember this. This is Chaos 2. Flipping your friend. It's a flipping frenzy out there, and that's what we wanted. Chaos 2 with George Francis and Bigger Brother, with Ian Watts at the controls and Joe Watts, the weapon operator. He's only 8, combining to send Bash up into the air and crashing down into the CPZ. Now they're after the flamethrower. They want to put Bash out of business for all time, I think. Bash into the CPZ and in trouble as the flamethrower. Has it come off, I wonder? I think the flamethrower has been discombobulated. In the corner, the ref bot comes in and says, hang on, I've had enough of this. What's going on? This is terrible teamwork against our boys. Matilda wants a little bit of revenge. Thermidor gets out of the way. Matilda, oh, is there a tear? I think there's a tear for Bash. Is there something going on between Matilda and Bash that we need to know about? We'll find out in the pits maybe a little bit later on. George France is in there. And Thermidor, the Thermidor team, look at this. With a little flip, not on Matilda, but on Chaos 2. Chaos 2 is overturned. George Francis may smile. And Thermidor 2, at long last, has taken on one of the other competitors here. Now dodge that flywheel of Matilda. Thermidor 2 taking on Matilda's tusks. That's better. Will he be cheesed out of it? I think immobilised top left. Only Thermidor's left to fight here. It's a wearying contest. Too much use of the flipper can leave you tired and drained, obviously. Oh, and one last onslaught. Thermidor is the winner of this. Matilda left alone for the house robots. Well done, Thermidor.
Well, the flipping frenzy turns into flipping carnage with all the house robots taking a flipping bashing. Let's hear it for the mighty flippers!
It was supposed to be a test of who had the mightiest flipper in Robot Wars, and they just all ganged up on the house robots.
Well, put that many flippers in the ring at once, what do you expect? Want to be the first to get a house robot over the fence. Didn't quite make it.
You were quite close, though, weren't you?
We were trying hard.
Hey, come here. Hey, look at this. Hey, look at them. Okay, they... Poor losers indeed. Now, go back to your toys. Gone. Go back to your toys. Well, all I can say is that Thermidor were actually the only contestant robot still moving at the end of the flipping frenzy. So I declare you, personally, the winners! Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Thermidor! We were looking for a mighty flipper, big and bad and mean, and we found it here in Thermidor on Robot Wars Extreme. Bye-bye.